Hey there, welcome to another episode of Coding with CodeCat 15. This is Ravi. While using arrays or dictionaries, aapne kabhi na kabhi map, filters, contains, removal jaise functions ka use kiya hoga. And when you google them, to in function ke bare mein ye kaha jata hai ki these functions are higher order function. But ye higher order function hota kya hai aur ye normal function se alag kaise hai? From knowledge and interview point of view, I think har ek Swift developer ko in dono ke beech ka difference malum hona chahiye. Higher order function jo term hai, it comes from functional programming world. In Swift, this is how we write a function and this is how it is read. Get employee by ID is the function name, jo ek single integer value accept kar raha hai as its input parameter, and the output or the return type is an optional employee object. Optional employee object is liye kyunki Swift mein we use the question mark to indicate the optional type. But the real difference between a regular function and a higher order function is that they accept other function as an input parameter, and they may return a function as an output. Since Swift is a functional programming language, it is very easy to create your own higher order function. Here's an interesting question I have for all of you. Itne saalon tak hame object oriented programming ke fayde bataye gaye, and now all of a sudden we are hearing about this functional programming. So I think we should also do a discussion sometimes in the future between object oriented and functional programming. But for now, let us focus on higher order function. The first example is a function accepting another function as an input parameter. Let's say I have a very simple function named say good morning, jo ek string input parameter accept kar raha hai, and it prints the message good morning appended by the name. I create one more function with the name greet user. Here's something special about this function. Ye function ka input parameter thoda sa alag hai. This function accepts a closure as its input parameter, and closures are nothing but function. If you're new to closures, I recommend watching my video on closures to know more about them, and you can do that by clicking on the I button on the top right hand side corner. Let's see ki hum greet user ko call kaise karenge. As you can see, we have passed say good morning function as the parameter to greet user. Let's quickly have a look at the example of a function returning another function as its output. Create good morning greeting function is a function that accepts a simple string as its input and returns a function as its output. The function which is being returned is a hello world function jo ek string return karta hai. As you can see, I am returning the hello world function, and finally this is how you call the function. Functional programming mein bahut sare new concepts hai and reasons hai ki why a function is accepting another function as the parameter ya fir ek function dusre function ko as a output kyu return karega. And I am talking about the technical reason behind this behavior. And in the coming sessions, we will surely answer this question. I would like to say, agar aapka use case demand karta hai ki aap higher order function likho, then please go ahead and do that. And if not, then please try to keep your code as simple and as readable as you can. Here are some of the higher order functions that are available in Swift, which I am aware of and which you will see me use in the coming session. I hope this session was helpful to you. And if it was, then please do subscribe and share this channel with your iOS group on Facebook or WhatsApp. You can ask me question on this topic via comment ya fir aap mujhe email kar sakte ho. My email ID is codecat15@gmail.com. That being said, this is Ravi. See you next time. Bye-bye.